Good morning, boys. Today we will see the exercise number 7.2. It is mainly deals stock shares, debentures, and brokerage. So first, you should know what is mean by the stocks and shares. So a businessman wants to start a business. He will if the person has that amount which is required to start the business, then there is no question of studying the shares, stocks, and debentures. Clear? So when the person doesn't have money, he has only little money, but he have good infrastructure and good persons to do the business in good manner. So he wanted to get the money. He wanted to involve the others also into that business. He wants the people, the others, third person, to be the partner of the particular companies. So what he will do? He has the money, initial amount. To run the business, he need more money, for which he decided to divide that investment into number of units. How we divide that capital into number of units? That businessman assign the cost of one unit is 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 25 rupees, 20 or up to 100 rupees. That is depends upon the government procedures. Clear? So he decide to costing the one unit as 10 rupees. Then it will be very easy to find out total number of units for the investment. For example, the businessman need 10,000 rupees. This is an example. So he wants 10,000 from the other persons because he don't have money this much. So he decided to collect the 10,000 rupees from the number of other persons, from a third persons or second persons, for which he divide that money 10,000 into number of units. You cannot divide the 10,000 into number of units simply, for which he consider that he assign the cost of one unit is 10 rupees. So if you know cost of one unit is 10, then I can easily find out number of units, that is total investment by cost of one units. Clear? So 10,000 by 10. So when you cancel, you get how many shares, how many units? 1000 units. These 1000 units will be released in the market, but the person cannot be launched straight away to the public. He has one mediator, that is called a broker. Clear? So most of you know, most of your parents doing the share business deposit, and so they know very well how they are getting the shares. You cannot get directly from the company, you have to get through the brokers. Clear? So the person fixed the cost of one unit is 10. So finally he got how many units? 100 units. Each units are called shares. When it comes to the market, that unit is renamed as share. Clear? When the units, the 1000 units come into that market, that is, he is ready to sell this one. For example, Reliance. Once the Reliance or Tata means, they have good name. Therefore, the demand of purchasing share will be more. So when the demand is more, automatically that cost of the units is more than the 10 rupees. Clear? Okay, that will come later. So what is meant by share? Share is nothing but units. Number of units is called shares. Clear? One who buy the share is called shareholders. What is meant by a stock? The share purchased by particular person. I got 100 shares. I kept it with me. That is my stock. When it comes to the market, it is when the shares will come to that other person, it is called market price. The stock value fixed cost by the company is called face value. The fixed cost is called face value. If it is less than 100 or less than 100, it is called face value. It is more than 100, the same is called what? Stock value. That's the difference between the face value and the stock value. Both are same only, but only the word is different. Face values can never cross 100. If it is more than 100, 10,000, 20,000, even if it is say the face value, that face value may be considered as what? Stock value. That is stock. We are buying the bulk of shares. One person buy the bulk of share is called what? Stock. So those are called stock holders. One who buy the shares is for share holders. Now that I said, if it is when the company is branded company like Tata and Maruti, that is Tata, TVS, Reliance. So once you know the name of these companies, then people knows that they are doing well. Therefore, this is fixed by the company, 10 rupees as a face value. So once it is launched into the market, if it is depends upon the company product, depends upon the company product and the company performance, this may be increased. That cost of the one share may be more than 10 rupees or less than 10 rupees. More than the face value or less than the face value, the face value fixed by the company, the direction of the government of India or government of some other country, wherever the company is situated. So the face value is decided by the company with consult with that government, particular state, country's government, that is face value. So depends upon the performance of the company, the face value more than the fixed rupees or less than the fixed rupees. If it is more than that face value, it is called premium. Clear? If it is more than the face value, suppose when the shares launched in the market, so the 10 rupees will become the cost of the share. Cost of the share is 15. So now, how much rupees will be increased from 10 to 5? 10 to 15, 5 rupees. So the 5 is called what? Premium. So more than the face value is called premium. Sometimes when the company is not performed well, automatically the cost will be reduced than the face value, like say 6 rupees or 2 rupees. In this case, we are losing 4 rupees as loss, is called discount. So more than the face value is called premium, less than the face value is called discount. Clear? It is depends upon the performance of the company. That's why some of them are got more profit by investing the share, some of them got lose everything. So the share is nothing but like gambling. Clear? You cannot predict. Some reputed company you can predict, but if you go for in depth, then you may get, even that reputed company will give you loss to you. So the shares is mainly the gambling. So depends upon the sum of the company, they created that artificially the demand of the shares to get more money. So once they demanded created artificially, so the some of them are willing to buy the more shares because of the money. Suddenly the share will come down, automatically they will lose money even in that reputed companies. Clear? Now there are two types of shares. Now you know what is meant by premium and discount. More than the face value is called premium, less than the premium face value is called discount. Now we have two type of shares. One is ordinary shares and another one is preferred share, preferential share. Preferential share, preferential shares, ordinary share or equity shares. There are two types. Preferential shares, common share or equity shares. Clear? So what is overall comes under the common shares or equity shares? The public. Then overall come under the preferential share or preferred shares, the company owners, directors. Clear? So that's why the company, if you take any companies, there are so many directors are appointed. So those are all comes under preferred shares. one who buy the individual, if I am getting the shares from the particular Reliance or Tata, I am called common shareholders. Clear? So the dividend, the profit of the company is not divided equally to the common shareholders as well as the preferential shareholders. They will not share like that. Clear? They will take some part of the profit separately, and remaining the profit only is shared by the common shareholders by keeping some rate of dividend, like 6%, 5%. Clear? So when the company earns 10,000, they will not give all the 10,000 to the common shareholders. So they will take some amount, like 6,000 for preferential shareholders. The remaining 4,000 rupees only go for what? Common shareholders with some dividend percentage. Clear? Don't think that the total profit of the company is divided into all the common shareholders. They will not do. Because we are not doing anything to the company. We are just investing the money, that's all. But the company is run by the directors. They are only working, like working partners. Some of your parents may do the business with working partners. So working partner and partners are totally different. Clear? Investing the money and invest the money along with working that same company. So that is called working partner. So these are all the preferential shareholders or working partners. They are investing the money as well as they are working to improve that quality of or the performance of the company. Therefore, they have separate dividend, and the common shareholders invest only the money. There is no connection in the working process in the company. They are called common shareholders. They have different dividend percentage. Clear? Don't think that the company will divide everything, the profit divided to everything to the common shareholders. They will not do. If they do, means that everybody in India will become an Ambani and Tata. Clear? So some percent they will take. The remaining percent only divided into the common shareholders. Clear? That's the difference between the preferential shareholders and common shareholders. Preferential shareholders, they have separate dividend of rate, and the common shareholders, they have different rate of dividends. Now, dividend is nothing but what? Income, interest. So, dividend is nothing but called interest, income, dividends. So, all are same concept. We have formula to find income. I am write down the formula. Income is equal to number of, N stands for number of share into percentage into face value. Clear? So, this is the formula. To find number of share, we have two formula. Investment by market value or market price. Then another one is stock value by face value. I told you already what is mean by stock value. If it is 10,000, 5,000, it is called, face value is renamed as stock value. Face value is never crossed more than 100, it will be maximum 100 rupees. Clear? So these are the formula to find income, number of shares. Clear? So this is, income is nothing but dividend. Sometimes it is also called what? Dividend. Clear? So when you, these are the formula, but we don't have the brokerage. Based on the brokerage, we don't have any problems in this exercise, but I will explain what is meant by brokerage. So brokerage, so even if you go for a hunting any rented house, there will be a broker. So once you go approach him, he will ask some commission. The commission is nothing but what? Brokerage. Whatever the business, there will be a commission. We go to the tomatoes market, to get the tomato from one person to another one person, you have to pay some commission. The farmers to the consumer, from the farmer to the consumer, that is R. We are farmer to consumer, there will be one agent. He is called what? Brokerage. He has to pay the money. Clear? He will get money from both sides, buyer as well as seller. So that is called brokerage. So in brokerage, in shareholders, if you want to buy any shares, you have to pay brokerage. If you want to sell the same share to someone, you have to subtract the brokerage. Clear? So that is called broker. What is mean brokerage? If you like to buy one things from some person, share from one person, I have to pay the brokerage. The brokerage may be 0.5%, 1%, 2%. Depends upon the company, they will charge. So I have to pay brokerage. So if the same share is sold to the same person, I have to subtract the brokerage. Clear? So when you buy, you have to add the brokerage. When you sell, you have to subtract the brokerage. So based on this concept, there is no problems in this exercise. So just you should know what is mean by the brokerage. Clear? So now, so this is the main important formulas. Then you can go through the formulas. Clear? So then, selling price, or sometimes it is called investment. Selling price sometimes is called as investment. Depends upon the question. We consider the selling price as investment. We have the selling price like face value into number of share. N stands for number of share, or market value into number of shares. So these are the formula to find out the selling price or investment. Clear? So sometimes it is called stock value also. Depends upon the questions. Clear? So this is a logical problem. It is. So therefore, depends upon the question, you have to consider the selling price, sometimes investment. When it comes under market value, so this is mainly this investment stands for market value into number of share. For stock value, face value into number of shares. Clear? So selling price, we have two formulas. Sometimes the same selling price called stock value. And when you go for market value, the same stock value is named as what? Investment. Clear? So these are the formula. Based on this formula, we will see some problems. Now, question number 1. The question number 1. Find the market value of 62 shares available at 132 having the par value of 100. What is the par value? Face value is equal to market value. Face value is equal to market value is called par value. When the face value is more, the market value is more than the face value, premium. Less than the face value, discount. If it is same, market value is equal to face value, it is called par value, that is given 100. That par value is considered as face value. Now, after the word at is always, you keep it in your mind, the rupees which is comes after the word at is always market value or market price. Now you are asked to find out the market value of 62 shares. That is called what? Investment. So you are buying 62 shares, which means you are investing. That is nothing but what? Selling price. Just now I wrote the formula. Investment or selling price. That is number of share into market value. Why I am using here investment? Because market value is given at 132. Clear? So number of share is 62. Market value is 132. Please use calculator and multiply and write. You will get 8184. Clear? So investment or selling price, both are same only. No, I am buying, which means I am investing my money into that company. That is my investment or selling price. Depends upon the question you have to take, whether it is selling price or investment. But more of both are same. Same formula you have to use to find selling price. Whenever you have market value, you have to take that selling price as what? Investment. Now the question number 2. How much will be required to buy 125 of 25 shares? Yeah, rupees will comes after the word of is always called face value. Yeah, rupees will comes after the word of is always called what? Face value. Keep it in your mind. And a rupees comes after the word of is always called face value. So now the face value is how much? 25. Question number 2. Face value is 25. How much required to buy 125 shares? So number of share is 125. I have to find out that money, how much I have to invest, how much money I have to spend to buy 125 shares when the face value is 25. It is not given like this. If it is given like that, then I can write straight away stock value is equal to number of share into face value. Here I did not use investment because I am using the face value. Clear? When you use the face value, you have to take it as stock value. Don't confuse. Clear? If I am taking that market value, that is called investment. If I find the value selling price by using the face value, the selling price called what? Stock value. Don't confuse these two concepts. But here one more information is given in the question. Discount is given 7 rupees. Just now I said discount or premium depends upon the face value. What is your face value? 25. Now I am buying one share not at 25 rupees. Discount is given 7 rupees. So now market value is equal to face value minus discount. What will be the answer? 18. Clear. Now you have to find out selling price. Here the selling price is nothing but what? Investment. Because I am putting my money into the company, that is 125 into 18. Formula I gave already, number of share into market value. So just you have to multiply, you will get 2250. Clear. I am writing the answer alone, but you have to check. Now the question number 3. If the dividend received, dividend means what? Your income. When the income received from 9% of 20 shares, what is mean by here 20 share? Rupees 20, I told you already, after the word of is refers to only face value. Clear. Now sum number 3, what is your face value? Face value is given. So what is your face value for sum number 3? Face value is given very clearly. After the word of is always called face value, 20. Then rate of interest, that is rate of dividend, we call as D percent, 9%. The dividend is given, D is given as 1690. 1690. So I told you, sorry, 1620. I told you already, dividend is nothing but what? Income. So what is income formula? Number of share into percentage into face value. What is your income? Income is given already, 1620. I don't know what is number of share. That only I have to find out. Percentage is given already, 9/100. What is my face value? Is 20. Just you have to keep n that side. Transfer the remaining terms based on the mathematical rules. So simplify, you will get the n is equal to how much? 900. Clear. Just you have to simplify, you will get the answer. Number of shares equal to how much? 900. Boys, don't copy. You please start it to work it out. Just your, this is ordinary translation that you learnt already in the lawyer classes. I need n only. So when you transfer this one, this will take reciprocal of the right hand side. 100/9, 1/20. So this is simplify, you will get answer. Clear. So the very simple, only thing you have to understand the concept. The sum number 4. Mohan invested rupees 29,040 in 15% of 100 shares of company quoted at a premium of 20%. So see the first question, first line itself. Invested. What is the investment is given for the sum number 4? INV, investment. That is 29,040 rupees. Clear. What is the percentage? Return percentage is given 15%. Of 100, that is your face value is how much? 100. Now you tell me, what is your market value? Do you have any market value after the word at? No, but it is given very clearly at a premium. I told you already, your rupee will comes after the word at is always, that is preposition. After the preposition at is always called a market value. So what is given at a premium of 20%? What does mean by premium? Discount means you have to subtract. Premium means you have to add. I told you already. What is mean by premium? More than the face value is called premium. Less than the face value is called what? Discount. Now it is given this premium. Therefore you have to add. That is market value is equal to 100 plus 20, which will give you 120. Now you have to find out number of shares bought by Mohan. So what a formula to find number of share? There are two formulas. Stock value by face value or investment by market value. Depends upon the question, you have to select which formula is suitable for the given question. Clear. So which formula out of these two is suitable for the given question? This is not suitable one because there is no stock values given. It is given only investment. Therefore, you have to take only investment by market value. That is number of share is equal to 29040 by 120. So when you divide this one, What will be the answer? 242 shares. This is the answer for first subdivision. So answer for the second one, you are asked to find out income. What is the income formula? Already is there. Income is equal to number of share into percentage into face value. What is the number of share we found already? 242 into 15/100. It is given rate into face value 100. Just you have to simplify. Multiply these two. You will get answer 3630. Boys, you check. Don't write as it is. Now the third one. There are three subdivisions in the question number 4. Depends upon the question, you have to select the formula. It will be very easy. Only thing you have to remember the concept. Now the third subdivision of the same question. Return, percentage of return. That is, percentage of return is equal to income by investment into 100. This is the formula to find percentage of return. So what is your income? We found already 3630 by my investment is 29040 into 100. You just simplify, you will get 12 1/2 percentage. Clear? I am writing straight away answer. Please, you have to check. You can write this in terms of decimal also. Instead of writing that mixed fraction, you may write in decimal form. Both are same only. Clear? Now sum number 5. This is just like the sum number 4. Clear? Here it is given already number of share 400. You know how to find out investment. Investment formula, I gave already investment formula for sum number 5. First, the investment formula is what? Market value into number of share. So what is the market value is given here? Premium is given. So market value is, after the word half is given 10 rupees. So 10 plus 2.50, that is 12.50. So now I know market value. Number of share is also given 400. Use this formula. Substitute, you will get answer. Investment is equal to, that is 12.50 into 400. You will get that investment. After that investment, you can easily find out annual dividend. Dividend is nothing but what? Income. Dividend, incomes are same. Just you have to apply this formula, you will get answer. Then rate of interest, same formula. Clear? Only difference in the question number 5, first subdivisions. After that, you can easily find out the remaining part by using this formula. Clear? So now we'll go to sum number 6. Sum number 6. Very simple concept. Sundar bought of 10 shares paying 2% per annum. He sold them when the price rose to 23 and invested the proceeds in 25 shares paying 10% per annum at 18 rupees. Question number 6. Clear? Sundar bought 4,500 of 10 shares, paying 2% per annum. He sold them when the price rose to 23 and invested the proceeds in 25 shares of paying 10% per annum. So it's very, very simple. Actually, what is given in the question? Sundar bought 4,500 of 10 rupees. So 4,500 here is considered as what? Your stock value. That is 4,500 rupees worth of one stock. And the stock over share order cost face value allowable 10 rupees. Half copper or rupees in an sunan 10 face value is one. You have a face value up half copper and 10 rupees. And the 10 rupees face value. அப்ப இது வந்து 4% ஆஃப் 10 அப்படின்னா 4,500 அப்படிங்கிறது ஸ்டாக் வேல்யூ. ஸோ உனக்கு என்ன பண்றான், அந்த 4,500 ஸ்டாக் இருக்கு, அப்ப அவனுடைய டிவிடெண்ட் இன்கம் வந்து எவ்வளவு பர்சன்ட்? 2%. அவன் என்ன பண்றான், கொஞ்ச நாள் கழிச்சு அந்த 4,500 ருபீஸ் இருக்கிற ஸ்டாக்கை விற்கிறான். எப்ப விற்கிறான்? 23, அதாவது வந்து மார்க்கெட் பிரைஸ் வந்து 23 ருபீஸுக்கு போறப்ப. இப்ப இவங்க கிட்ட எவ்வளவு இருக்கு? 10 ருபீஸ் இருக்கு. மார்க்கெட் விலை எனக்கு என்னன்னு தெரியாது. மார்க்கெட் பிரைஸ் ஆஃப் the face value 10 is not given in the question. Be careful. Once the number is given after the word at is called a market value. In the first line la pathina andha mari tharala avan enna kuduthukan face value kuduthutan stock value kuduthutan market value enna theriyadu andha 4500 rupees oda stock oda market value enna theriyadu kudukala ana avan vikran eppa vikran ஒரு மார்க்கெட் பிரைஸ் இருக்கு. அந்த மார்க்கெட் வேல்யூ பிரைஸ் வந்து எப்ப வந்தா விக்கிறான், 23 ருபீஸ் வந்தோடனே வித்துறான். அப்படின்னா அந்த 4500 ருபீஸ் ஓட ஸ்டாக் ஓட மார்க்கெட் வேல்யூ என்னவா இருக்கும், 23 ருபீஸ் ஓட கம்மியா தான் இருக்கும். ஆனா எவ்வளவுன்னு தரல, கொடுத்துருக்கானுங்க கொடுக்கல. புரியுதா புரியலையா? ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் என்ன கொடுத்துருக்கானா, 4500 ரூபாய் ஓட ஸ்டாக் வேல்யூ, அதனுடைய ஃபேஸ் வேல்யூ 10 ருபீஸ். அவன் எப்ப விக்கிறான், அந்த 4500 ரூபாய் ஸ்டாக் வேல்யூவோட each stock share oda market value vandu evlo pogudhu 23 rupees ku vanda piragu vikkran. Appana avangatta stock irukrappa avanudaiya market price evlo irukum, 23 rupees vida kammiya da irukum, ana adu evlo nu theriyadhu. Ana vikkran eppa vikkran, adu 23 rupees varakku vikkran. Appa vikkrappa unak enna kadaikum, oru porula nodan vitta unak enna kadaikum, oru panam kadaikum. அந்த பணத்தை என்ன பண்ணலாம், நீ ஒன்னு செலவு பண்ணலாம், அப்படி இல்லைன்னு என்ன இந்த பணத்தை வந்து இன்னொரு இதில் போய் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் பண்ணலாம். ரெண்டு பாசிபிலிட்டிஸ் தானே, ஒன்று நீ வச்சுப்ப செலவு பண்ணலாம், அது வந்து உன்னுடைய பாசிபிள். இன்னொன்று என்ன, அந்த பணத்தை பேங்க்லயோ இல்லை வேற இதுலயோ போய் நம்ம சேவ் பண்ணலாம். அதான கான்செப்ட். அப்ப அவன் என்ன பண்றான், 4500 ருபீஸ் உள்ள ஸ்டாக் இருக்கிற ஒரு மார்க்கெட் பிரைஸோட வேல்யூ 23 இருக்கிறப்ப வித்துறான். விற்கிறப்ப அவனுக்கு ஒரு பணம் கிடைக்கும். அந்த பணத்தை என்ன பண்றான், இன்னொரு ஷேர்ல போடுறான். அந்த ஷேர்ல போடுறப்ப அந்த ஷேரோட ஃபேஸ் வேல்யூ என்னன்னு கொடுக்குறான், 25 ருபீஸ் கொடுத்துட்டான். ஆனா அதோட மார்க்கெட் வேல்யூ என்ன கொடுத்துருக்கான் பாரு, அப்படியே வந்து என்ன பாரு அந்த லைன்ல, இன்வெஸ்டட் தி ப்ரோசீட்ஸ் இன் 25 ஷேர்ஸ் பேயிங் 10% பர் ஆனம் அட் 18. அட்டுக்கு அப்புறம் என்ன வந்திருக்கு, 18, அதாவது 23 ரூபாய்க்கு வர்றப்ப வித்துட்டு வர்ற பணத்தை 18 ரூபாய் இருக்கிற 18 ருபீஸ் இருக்கிற ஒரு ஷேர்ல போய் போடுறோம். அப்ப அவனுக்கு லாபம் தானே, ஏன்னா 23 ருபீஸ்ல வித்துட்டு காசு நிறைய வந்துடும். ஆனா இன்னொரு ஷேர்ல போடுறப்ப எவ்வளவு போடுறான், 23 ருபீஸ்ல கம்மியா இருக்கிற ஒரு ஷேரை வாங்குறான். அப்படி வாங்குறப்ப ஏற்கனவே எவ்வளவு இருக்கு, 4500 ருபீஸ் இருக்கிறப்ப அவனுக்கு எவ்வளவு இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் வருது, 2% வருது. அப்ப அவனுக்கு ஒரு டிவிடெண்ட் அந்த டைம்ல வந்திருக்கும் பழைய ஷேர்ல. இப்ப இன்னொரு ஷேர் வாங்கியிருக்கான், 18 ருபீஸ்ல ஒரு ஷேர் வாங்கியிருக்கான், அப்ப அதுலயும் ஒரு இன்கம் வரும் இல்லையா, அதனுடைய இன்கம் பர்சன்ட் என்ன கொடுத்திருக்கான், 10% கொடுத்திருக்கான். அப்ப இந்த ப்ராசஸ்ல ஒரு பொருளை வித்து இன்னொருல போடுறப்ப வர லாபம் என்னன்னு கேட்கறான். ஏற்கனவே என்கிட்ட இருந்தப்ப எவ்வளவு வருமானம் வந்ததுன்னு முதல்ல நான் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். இப்ப புதுசா வாங்கின ஸ்டாக்ல இருந்து எவ்வளவு எனக்கு வருமானம் வரும்னு கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். ரெண்டு வருமானத்தையும் கம்பேர் பண்ணா எனக்கு ஏற்கனவே இருந்த வருமானம் பரவாயில்லையா இல்ல இப்ப வர வருமானம் பரவாயில்லையான்னு கண்டுபிடிக்கலாம். புரியுதா? இதுதான் வந்து க்வெஸ்சன். இதை எப்படி போடுறது, ஷேர்ஸ் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். முதல்ல வந்து நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஷேர் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஷேருக்கு என்ன ஃபார்முலா, ரெண்டு ஃபார்முலா இருக்குன்னு சொன்னேன் முன்னாடி சம்மலே. பட் யூ ஹாவ் டு ஹியர் யூஸ் ஒன்லி தட் ஃபாஸ்ட் ஸ்டாக் வேல்யூ பை ஃபேஸ் வேல்யூ, பிகாஸ் ஸ்டாக் வேல்யூ இஸ் கிவன் அஸ் தட் திஸ் இஸ் த க்வெஸ்சன் நம்பர் 6. ஸ்டாக் வேல்யூ இஸ் கிவன் 4500, தி ஃபேஸ் வேல்யூ ஆஃப் தி ஸ்டாக் இஸ் கிவன் 10 ருபீஸ். சோ வென் யூ டிவைட் யூ கெட் ஹவ் மெனி ஷேர்ஸ், 450. நவ் ஹி இஸ் ஃபைண்ட் செல்லிங் பிரைஸ், தட் இஸ் கால்ட் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட். சோ செல்லிங் பிரைஸ் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஷேர்ஸ் into that market value. He sold this by when the market value is reached 23. So you have to multiply, you will get answer 4, that is 450 into that income, 450 into 23, 10,350. So this money is going to be invested on some other market value, but you have to find income from the first one. Income 1, when you have the stock value as 4500, you have to find income, that is number of share into percentage into face value. I found already number of share is how much, 450 into what the percentage is given for the first type of share, 2%, that is 2 by 100. What is your face value, face value is given as 10. Just you have to multiply, you will get 10 get cancelled. So what will be the answer, 90. So I got I1, that is income from the first stock, I got 90 rupees. Now I know the investment, this is the investment for what, next share. What is the formula to find investment, number of shares, or number of share you can replace investment by market value or market price percentage into face value. Clear? So what is your investment? Investment is 10,350. What is your market price at the stage? That is 18. Into that percentage is given. What is the percentage? Is given 10%. 10/100 into what is your face value for the second one? 25. So simplify, you will get answer straight away. I'll write down the answer: 1437.50. Now that income from the second one is more. So you have to write that investment on the second share is better, but you have to find the difference. That is, difference is equal to I2 minus I1. That is 1437.50 minus 90. Just you subtract, you will get answer. We will see the remaining problems. Only we have 4 problems that we will see in the next class, boys. Thank you.